Hello everyone, we are the students of Holmes Institute Sydney and today we are going to show a video related to the legal aspects of international trade and enterprise. The members of our group are Saima Naureen, Ashwani Sehaj, Bhanu Pratap Singh and myself Sukhjinder Kaur. Our topic of the presentation is the case of Amarnath Sehgal versus Union of India, in which we are going to show the moral rights of an artist over his work were put to the test in a High Court of India in 1992, in what was to become a 13-year legal battle finally settled in 2005. First of all, I will show you the main contents of the presentation that include facts, issues, analysis, judgment and conclusion. In the case of Amarnath Sehgal is recognized as the plaintiff, whereas the Union of Government is treated as the defendant. Mr. Amarnath Sehgal is the world-renowned sculptorist and has been conferred with several awards for his beautiful creations and contribution to the Indian heritage. In the year 1959, the Government of India commissioned Mr. Sehgal for creating the bronze mural for the most prominent international conventional hall in the capital of the country. The design was given the green flag by the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and it took around 5 years to complete and placed in 1962 on the walls of the lobby of Vigyan Bhavan. This embellishment on a national architecture became a part of the Indian heritage. In its final shape, it measured a mammoth 40 feet high and 140 feet in length. The background of the present dispute was set in the year 1979 when government pulled down the sculpture from the walls of Vigyan Bhavan and dumped in the storeroom. When Mr. Sehgal came to know of this ill treatment, he made representations to the government authorities for restoration of the mural. Unfortunately, all his plans fell on deaf ears. Then there were many other issues raised, and these issues were raised by the plaintiff, as the plaintiff asserted that the Indian government destroyed the mural without any notification to him. Also, the government refused to give the plaintiff any remedy or compensation for the loss. The government claimed that they have the possession to the mural. Moreover, the plaintiff stated that the pulling down and improper handling of the mural caused immense damage to the mural, which resulted in the disappearance of the parts of the mural, including the name of its creator. As per the plaintiff, such damage was prejudicial to his reputation and hence he prayed for the applicable laws. And these applicable laws are such as a declaration of special rights under Section 57 of the Copyright Act 1957. He also prayed for a permanent injunction to restrain the defendants from further distorting, mutilating or damaging the mural. Damages towards compensation for humiliation, injury, insult and loss of plaintiff's reputation. After all these circumstances, there are certain arguments on behalf of the plaintiff as well as by the defendant. The plaintiff contended that over the years, the mural had acquired the status of a national treasure, representing the essential part of Indian art heritage. The destruction of the mural, which was done without his permission, consent or authorization of the plaintiff, violated his special rights under Section 57. The ministry action was prejudicial to his honor and reputation as an artist because by reducing the mural to junk, it dealt a body blow to the esteem and celebrity bestowed on the work at its inception. On the other hand, defendant objected at the outset to the court to intervene in the matter and argued that the plaintiff had assigned his copyright to the defendant in an agreement dated on 31st October 1916. Moreover, since the plaintiff had already been paid the price for the work, the ownership of the mural lied with the defendant. They also claimed that the mural had already been damaged in a fire in Vigyan Bhavan. Also, according to the terms of the 1960 agreement, any grievances should be referred to an arbitrator appointed by the defendant. In the second round of the battle, the judge held in the Mr. Sehgal's favor by dismissing the defendant's application to refer the dispute to arbitration. Finally, the evidence was led and the matter came up for final hearing. In the third key decision, Justice Pradeep Nandra Jog of the Delhi High Court ruled that all rights of the mural shall henceforth vest with Mr. Sehgal. There are identification rights or attribution rights, right to dissemination, right to integrity, that is to maintain the purity of work, and right to withdraw from the publication of the work. It further held that the authorities not only violated the plaintiff's moral right with respect to the mural, but also violated the integrity of work in relation to the cultural heritage of the country. Hence, the court ordered the authorities of the convention center to return the remainder of the mural to the plaintiff and also slapped damages of rupees 5 lakh on the defendant. But the fight was still not quite over. The decree was not fulfilled, and Mr. Sehgal took again recourse to the court in execution proceedings. While the defendant appealed against the decree to a division bench of the court, ultimately the matter was amicably resolved. After the hard-fought and emotional battle, Mr. Sehgal, grateful for his victory, waived the claim of damages against the government in exchange for the return of the mural. Finally, the case of Amarnath Sehgal's mural throws into relief the importance of the Section 57 provision of Indian Copyright Act and of the weight it has been accorded by courts in India. It also gives reason to thank the wisdom of those who resolved all those years ago that there should be a higher law to protect the soul and essence of artistic expression as much as or more than the physical or tangible form of that expression. Thank you for watching and listening this video. For more updates, please subscribe my channel below. Thank you.